gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Beautiful. Such great, great. During Lent, we are so blessed, dear brothers and sisters. The readings are so fabulous. I could talk about them for 5 hours, but obviously will not. Prophet Ezekiel has a manifestation of mercy and justice. These two concepts that are so, so important. Obviously, we've heard so much about these concepts. On one side, God is just. This is the way to heaven. This is what is right. This is what is wrong. It is not up to us to be God and to determine, oh, from now on, this thing that actually I like is what is going to be right. And this thing that actually I don't like is going to be wrong. And sometimes there is that correlation, sometimes there isn't. We do not have the authority to determine what is right and what is wrong. We do not have the knowledge, we do not have the intelligence, we do not have any of the things needed to be able to do that. So I think it's very important, both readings, the first reading in the Gospel, Jesus is saying, this is what is right. If you are angry with your brother, don't say, oh, well, such is life, tough, you know, you figure it out. It's your problem. He says, no, go and reconcile. Now, before, the standard was here, and he said, you cannot kill your brother. Well, no, I'm bringing the standard up. You should not be angry with your brother or sister. So on one side, it's justice. This is the path. This is what we need to do. But on the other side, it's mercy. God is forgiving. God is understanding. And it's so well represented in this first reading because God is a God of second opportunities, always offering the opportunity, saying, I don't expect you to reach here today. I know there's a gradual path, but it is important that mercy is in the direction of this. I'll give you an example. Let's say I am a drug addict. I use cocaine every day. And every day I go to the priest and say, hey, forgive me, please. God has mercy. Please forgive me. And the priest will say, okay, are you repentant? And that's the very important question, because that repentance means I do not want to follow drugs. I recognize that drugs is bad, and I want to do this. And then I'll be forgiven, because I'm orienting, I'm showing an intention that I want to follow this path, not using drugs. This one is a pretty easy one, because we kind of all agree, well, if it's not marijuana, that it's kind of wrong to use drugs. But even that one is kind of like, well, dicey. But there are many more. Any more? Can you just harbor anger in your heart against someone? Can you just judge someone? It is like, can you slander? Can you go on internet and everybody's like, oh, that's kind of okay. We all do it anyway. Hey, sorry, Jesus, we're doing it, but I'm going to do it again. So Jesus' mercy is true mercy. It's beautiful. Beautiful, but it's not permissive mercy. It's never going to tell you, yes, Father Carlos, no problem, I love you, just go on doing cocaine, that's great. Burn your brain out, destroy the life of the people around you, poof, that's what my mercy is for. This is not moral relativism. We are not entitled to say, cocaine is good, cocaine is bad. We are not the moral standard. It's so important, dear brothers and sisters. The judgment, the judge, there's only one judge in this whole universe, and his name is Jesus Christ. We follow. And that's not easy, dear brothers and sisters. There's a deep arrogance, deep pride, that sometimes is there, very, very, very hidden in our hearts, saying, is so prevalent. But mercy is there, even for the arrogant, even for those who think that they have the right way. Mercy is always there, calling